said to him, "Sorry, Ben." And he said, it wasn't out of my head. I heard this voice.
Yeah, wow.
And I did, and I repented, and he said I was in tears.
Yeah.
And I really felt God, His presence come on me. And He said, "John, change your ways and follow me." And when He saw me Thursday morning, when He saw me, He sort of grabbed me and said, "Trevor, this is what happened,
Yeah.
And He said, "I don't know what I said a couple of weeks ago." He said, "I don't know what it is, but I think you guys got into my subconscious." So that's when you did. You don't know, do you?
No.
Yeah,
that's so good.
It's
one.
Yeah,
it's
one.
The hell of a soft piece.
That is, yeah.
The hell of a soft piece.
Yeah, he's really on fire.
Taking David's advice, and this is the end of the song, but we'll go on to another one.
Praise you,
Men, warmth and light, and that is the basic for living.
Yeah, indeed.
Yeah. Well, that leads into, well and truly, well, we started off with the one about how light began in the beginning. That's the 6 days. And so what has triggered this off has been the largest growing church in the world, which is the Iranian church. They're under the persecution, but we've gone through the whole sort of thing of sheep among wolves, and they are round about in that area of making disciples at a greater rate, but they're not doing it in the conventional way. So that what's happening is that they have no churches, church buildings. They have people, that they have no bank accounts and such. Now, this is what I see is going to happen in the end time.
Yes.
We're
yes.
going to have those sort of areas where we're going to have those relationships
right.
with each other that is going to be strong. And so the way they don't see the way we disciple people in the Western world, in the Western church, because mostly what's happening here is that we go for converts. But their statement is that converts don't last in persecution. And it's good to realize that, because in Fox's Book of Martyrs, it was the ones who were religious and going along with the benefits of Christianity at that time, but as soon as persecution came, many of them would follow Caesar
rather than take the persecution. But disciples, they say, disciples have loved not their life even unto death. So it builds on Revelation chapter 12, verses 10 and 11. And it comes back to that place of saying, okay, they love their lives not even unto death. It's the final part. Revelation 12 says, they overcame by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, and they loved not their lives even unto death. So over the next 3 weeks, we did the first one. Last week, they were looking at they overcame by the blood of the Lamb. This next week and the week after, we'll be looking at the simple reality of that the word of their testimony. And some of the testimonies within them are so amazing. Because they don't see. And this is what we're going to be looking at today. And we're going to concentrate on John chapter 8, because the way they do it is the way Jesus did it. You know, in John chapter 8, we're going to begin here, because first of all, I want to, before I started this, this has been going through my heart over since we saw that one, because I thought, now, the disciples we tend to lift up on a pedestal, you know, but we know they have faults, we know that, and somehow they are far above. All the people that we would value. But who is a disciple? Now, I'm not talking about Jesus' disciples. I looked at Mahatma Gandhi, and he had disciples. I look at so many, Mormonism, they have disciples. They believe that Jesus is the half-brother of Satan. And so if you're going to be a Mormon, you become a disciple of theirs, and you start to move in the things that they teach you. So a disciple is someone who is being taught. It's the Greek word mathetes, which is a pupil or a learner. Mathetes. What is it?
Mathetes.
Mathetes. Oh, like your. It's a bit like listening to your
He's Greek.
And so on that point, it all comes back to. He's a pupil or a learner. It's something that they're learning.
Yeah.
Now, Jesus chose them. They weren't already great men, were they? They were people that were fishermen. One was a tax collector. And so it comes back to that place that we look at the way things go today. We've got leaders in the Western Church, and we hit on them today. You can go to the different denominations and you've got leaders there.
Oh, yes.
You've got people that in Catholicism, for example, the Pope is the revered leader, the Vicar of Christ, so called. Now, the Holy Spirit is the only Vicar of Christ, but he is the one who makes pronouncements ex cathedra. In other words, he cannot make a mistake when he pronounces a thing ex cathedra. And all the Catholics worldwide have to go along with that, otherwise they can't be a Catholic. Now, he made a statement in the 1850s, I think, that Mary was not conceived in sin, therefore she was perfectly. And disagrees with God completely. Because my soul doth magnify the Lord, my spirit doth rejoice in God,
my
Saviour. So she needed a Saviour. Now, the Pope ignores. Now, I'm not down in Catholic. I've got a lot of Catholic friends. I met him over in the Moon Cafe this morning. I said, "We've got a book for you to read, Peter. I think you'll enjoy it because it's anti-abortion." Now, they are anti-abortion, and I stand up with them for that. But I don't stand with their doctrine. When they say, "Hoc est in corpus mea, this is my body," the priest doesn't have the magic words to say to bring about the physical presence of Jesus, so that when they have communion, Jesus is being brought into living reality. Like, this is why I can't have communion in the Catholic Church. I was brought up Catholic. I know that. I had years and years of that. I went into the seminaries, and God delivered me from that. And instead of living in a place where the cemetery could have brought me to a cemetery, I was able to move to a place where God has now come into that place where I'm not there, am I? I just want to lift up Jesus. This is where anything that is said here today, and I say it all the time, you have to check it out against the word yourself. You know, if I'm in error,
and live it.
And live it in the Spirit. That's what Gandhi, he had disciples. And he didn't have the idea of, he was against education that would lead to careers. His disciples, they said, you learn from your moral position in the way that as you go through your life, you actually learn all those things necessary, and he did some crazy things. But in January 1948, he was killed by Hindu extremists because they didn't think he was making a good picture of there. And you see, in Protestantism, you know, people follow people these days, they follow me. Paul.
Yes.
Look, let me read this to you. In 1 Corinthians 1, 11 to 13, there is a clear warning. For it has been declared unto me of you, my brethren, by them which are of the house of Chloe, that there are contentions among you. Now this I say, that every one of you saith, I am of Paul, I am of Apollos, I am of Cephas, and I of Christ. Is Christ divided? You know, so in effect, what we've done this, and I'm saying this very carefully because we must lift up Christ. It says, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. So, and if you stand out on that and you come into those places where people say, no, you've got to have fellowship. You've got to have fellowship. Well, I fellowship all over the world.
I agree with fellowship.
Yes. With believers. I'm not going to have fellowship with a Mormon. I'm going to pray for them. I reach out to Mormons. I don't. Islam. They have disciples in Islam. And this is the strength of the Iranian church. They are taught discipline from a very early age.
Yeah.
Read the Quran. Yeah. Read the Quran.
Yeah.
Don't understand it. Don't read in Arabic. Who knows Arabic? Now I go down the mall and I say, you're reading English translation, but pick for translation, English translation. But he said, no, that's not the Arabic. That's not the Arabic. Now they are well and truly trained to, a bit like the Catholic Church when you had Latin. You learned Latin, you know, and you actually had those things.
Do you know the Pope, his name at the moment, is in 1962, he did make a decree that all Latin would be not discarded, but that all scriptures would be read in the language of the culture and the language of the people. 1969,
yes.
That took how many years? 12, 11 thousand years that the people were in dark.
Yeah, because that's it. But this is where we come into that. But in Islam with the Arabic, they come into that place where they're indoctrinated. If you're disciplined, all right. You have your five pillars. If you don't go along to the mosque, then you are not working alongside of the thing. But the Iranian church said the Ayatollah Khomeini was the best evangelist for them. Because he promised them 40 years ago, when he first came into power, that he would make the whole of Iran an example to the world of prosperity. He lied. And the people realized that he lied. So now the mosques are empty. And the people go through the form of religion, a bit like the West, really. They go through the form of religion,
yeah.
But they don't know the truth of what God has got. So, you follow what I'm. I want to make a point there about how disciples are people end up following a particular line It's who the person is that they're following becomes important. Would you agree with that?
Yes.
If you don't follow the person explicitly and implicitly, you can't be their disciple. So let's turn to John chapter 8. I think this will be very, very plain what we need to look at here. And John chapter 8, starting to verse 12. Now I'm going to read this through. And we're going to pick out some things here that are very, very important for us to realize. John chapter 8, verse 12, starting there. Then spake Jesus again on them, I am the light of the world. He that followeth me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life. That was what you were saying about that particular verse. We were saying also about in the beginning there is light, that there is darkness and there is light. But he is the light of the world. That's Jesus' words.
Amen.
He is the light of the Pharisees, therefore, under him, you bear record of yourself. Your record is not true. So immediately you've got that opposition. Now you listen to what Jesus said. So Jesus answered and said unto them, though I bear record of myself, yet my record is true. For I know whence I came and whither I go, but ye can't tell whence I come and whither I go. You judge after the flesh. I judge no man. Mm-hmm. See, this is what Luke was saying before. If you have spiritual eyes to see, you'll see. If you walk after the spirit, you'll live. If you walk after the flesh, you'll die. So this is what's been here. If you've got the spiritual eyes to see, you will truly see. You judge after the flesh, I judge not. And yet if I judge, my judgment is true. For I am not alone, but the Father that sent me. It is also written in your law that the testimony of two men is true. I am one that bears witness of myself, and the Father that sent me bears witness of me. Then said they unto him, you're not giving up, are they? It's like you get people that want to continually argue.
It's on.
You neither know me, nor my Father. If you had known me, you should have known my Father also. Now that's quite simple. He says, remember the disciples? Show us your Father. He says, if you've seen me, you've seen the Father. So we've got this here. And the word spake Jesus in the treasury as he taught in the temple. No man laid hands on him, for his hour's not yet come. I reckon this is important because we've got to know that, like you, you've got that word. And 5 years ago, Missy got a word about you know, I'd still be now. And so this is where we rely on the word of God, not what man says. You brought something exactly in line with what we're seeing here today. And I go my way, and you shall seek me, and shall die in your sins. Where I go, you cannot come. Then said the Jews, see, their reason. People look after that. Now, I'm like that. Sometimes I misunderstand things. Like, I didn't know so many good things that have been going on for 21 years that I thought, you know, not that I was the only prophet around the area, but I'm saying that there are others around there. Now my eyes are open and I'm just rejoiced that that's happened. Then said the Jews, will he kill himself because he says, whither I go, you cannot come? And he said unto them, you are from beneath, I am from above. You are of this world, I am not of this world. I said therefore unto you that you shall die in your sin. For if you believe not that I am he, you shall die in your sins. That's pretty clear, isn't it?
Mm, very basic.
What that spoke to me when my son was trying to convince me that Jesus is not God, he's got a family of Michael. When I looked at that, Jesus is made it very clear, and that he was added, he said, I am God.
Yeah.
That's what he's saying.
That's exactly
right. That made him the supreme authority.
Mm. Yep. So, yep.
Not anything else,
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Then said they unto him, Who are you? And Jesus said unto them, Even the same that I said unto you from the beginning. I have many things to say and to judge of you, but he that sent me is true. And I speak to the world those things which I have heard of him. They understood not that he spake to them of the Father. And then Jesus said unto them, When you have lifted up the Son of Man, then shall you know that I am he, and that I do nothing of myself, but as my Father has taught me, I speak these things. And he that sent me is with me. The Father hath not left me alone, but I do always those things that please me. As he spake those words, many believed on him. Now, this is the part, I've done all that part there, because they believed on him, because of what he said. Many believed. Now, we've got many people that believe today, that sit in the church, and they believe so many things. But then, listen to this. Then said, in verse 31, Then said Jesus to those Jews which believed on him, this wasn't unbelievers. This is people that truly believe. And he says this, if you continue, the word continue, if you continue in my word, then are you my disciples indeed.
Amen.
It's not someone who hears the word like the sower and the seed. They hear the word, they believe for a time, and they fall on stony ground, and the devil comes along and picks up. He hates the word being preached.
Oh, yes.
He hates the word being believed. But he even hates it even when people decide that they're going to do something about it. If you continue in my word, then are you my disciples indeed. And you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Yeah. They still go on arguing. But I'm going to stop there. I want that to sink in with us today. Because there are many people who call themselves Christians these days, but they are not disciples. They are not the disciples of Jesus. You can be a disciple of Buddha. You can be a disciple of Hinduism. You can follow the Lama. You can be a rabbi's disciple. You know, you've got different rabbis over in Israel right now, and they have different people that follow them. Totally different people. And depending on what they have, you know, some, you know, the ones with the big rocks on the side?
Yes.
The ones are there, you know. I feel like I want to tie it up underneath the chin, because it wriggles around and everything. But you see, they've got different sort of things around the way. Hey, hang on, mate. What? This is the time for the word. And it's not time to be glib about what's that, because God will want to take away something from today. Because if you're a disciple of Jesus, then you will follow his word. Now, how do we hear his word? Well, through reading it. You don't have to get a Bible that gives you all the best sort of thing. You know, I see many Bibles in Coorong these days that give you the opinions that... And I can. When I come to the commentaries, it's at that place where, okay, it gives me something, but I find some of the commentaries very good each other. You go back to the Greek and the Hebrew.
Some
and
of them are sort of very good, though.
Some are good.
But every commentary is like a person's nose.
Yes.
Everybody's got a nose. Everybody's got an opinion.
Yeah, but yes. Sometimes in those things. But at the same time, we've got a place where the beauty of it is that if you were a Catholic, you'd read the Knox Bible. Yeah, the Knox Bible is just not to give you any understanding. Or you'll read the Jerusalem Bible, but it will have the apocrypha and all that stuff. Now, at the same time, we have the Holy Spirit. John 15, John 17. Now, the beauty of that is that the Holy Spirit can, you come to him. Now, the Iranian Christians, they pray each day, God, lead me to someone who has already got a prepared heart. Now, wouldn't it be needy if every Christian, particularly in the Western world, said, lead me to someone this day that you've prepared. Lead me. And then, when he leads you to that, you know, I've been amazed that sometimes I've missed the leadings of God. Have you ever done that?
Mm-hmm.
You know, you go, oh, missed opportunity. And then you start beating yourself up, well, I'm not as good as what I thought I was. Well, that's good, because God can humble you to make you rely on Him even more in the future. So that's the wonderful part. But the disciple of Jesus, we're going to have so many deceivers these days. And our place is not to lift ourselves up.
Mm.
Our place is to point people to Christ. To point them to the one. See, you look at the early church, their role was to gather together, to build each other up, to have communion, to share in communion, and to move in prayer, find out what God wants them to do. In Acts 13, you've got the Holy Spirit decides what Paul and Barnabas are going to do. It isn't like having a community. I like what Spurgeon says, and I know I'm referring to Spurgeon's paper. He says, and William Booth said this, some of my best men are women. And he also said, well, even from there, he said, it's the people that have to rely on the Holy Spirit to really guide and to teach them. Keep your ear to the ground, keep your ear to what God is saying. There is much noise out there today. And I trust the noise that I'm making.
Elijah went out of the cave after the wind had smashed the rocks and the fire and an earthquake and a massive noise. But Elijah went out to a still small voice. God was so quiet, he just whispered.
Yep, yep.
You have to be.
Yep. We have to be sensitive in there. That takes minds. But I think with Paul and Barnabas, with the Holy Spirit saying, send Paul and Barnabas to the work whereunto I have called them. And this is what I'm praying today, that we will have a people that will be not relying on one person. Like today we've had many words preached today through each person that has come to a place where God has used them. I'm glad you're here today. That word that you have in relation to what God said to you, that's encouragement. It's exactly in line with what I'm saying today and with what God is doing. We need to be disciples of Jesus.
Disciples. And there's a fight in that too, though, because the enemy comes along and says, no, that word's not for you, though. Oh, but I'm the King James Father, you're not talking to me? That promise is not mine? What have I done wrong? You know? So
I know.
Hang on to it and say this is me. Yes. Yeah. 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 Ye
The truth. Yeah, and that's what it is. He is the truth. You shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Now, the truth is not something you get from 50 Chapman, who says, I'm consulting with my professor. I'm consulting with my expert. I'm consulting with this that says that the baby is not a baby until it comes through the birth canal. No, that is not the truth. The truth is that I knew you before you were even born. I value you because you are known of me. I knew you even before you were even born. But this is our God, and this is the God we need to honor. Pray for our parliament that we can get on and do the things that we need to do. So they leave us alone while they get on with our other business. I don't care really now whether or not that gets through on March the 2nd. I don't really care whether it does, because that's not going to alter my position. And because God is still God. Mm-hmm. He is the one who has said, I hate the shedding of innocent blood. The blood is still innocent. The blood is still innocent. they will have to answer for it. Mm. And God hates it. Oh, but you can't say God hates, because God is love. No, no, that's garbage. It's the word of God is true. And so we don't need to listen to the others that want to distort what God is already saying. So I'll give you one impressive thing today. But if you're truly being His disciples, then continue in His word. Otherwise, if you get deviated off, you know, the beauty of this is that Islam, they're so disciplined by Islam, that when they come over into Christianity, they're disciplined as well. A lot of our Western church, people aren't disciplined. Oh, well, you know, you can have same-sex marriage in the various churches. They're apostate, they're totally off. Oh, it doesn't matter if the babies are killed before 22 weeks and 6 days, it doesn't matter. Oh, we'll agree with that because after all, the world, you know, it's modern. And it's all that, garbage. The word of God does not change. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And our God is a God who is a consuming fire.
Yeah.
Vicky Chapman, his life, when she comes to the end of it, she's going to place her maker as much as Justice Robin Williams, who started the first one, has already died, and he's faced that already. He regretted it. I've already written a letter saying that I hope you change your heart and soul. I'm praying for her soul that they will be changed. But God will hand over a reprobate mind if they don't want it. So, but continue in His word. That makes you a disciple.
He says,
you're going to have to stand alone.
He's a rewarder of those who
diligently seek Him.
A rewarder. You'll reward. He says, draw close to me and I will draw close to you.
Yep.
And then we have an effect on others.
Yes.
Talking about a surgery, I'm witnessing about Jesus, how he's actually going, and I was all black, but we can imagine, 40 stitches here.
Yeah.
They say, I said, it's Jesus. It's the Lord Jesus who's going to heal me. Yes. And then we're sort of standing away. So it's our witness as well.
Yes.
We've got the truth. We're standing confidently. Yes.
Yeah.
And we then tell others and say, listen, don't lose hope. Your doctor's told you you're going to die. Hang on a minute.
Yeah,
and accept Jesus, your Lord and Savior.
Yes.
He'll give you the truth for your life. Be true.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
We prayed for this. And we went back to the specialist, and she said, this is really good. And she had to have a dish that was all over to mention
there. So it's all there? It's all there? Still there?
Oh, no, it's part of it. Still there, but they could get rid of it.
You know that chemo on the radio is really bad for the glios?
We know that, yes.
Yes, because it sparks off the astrocytes and all those little cells.
We pulled out. They don't know that we did what we did.
Yes.
If we all three of us got they should be having something good right over there.
Yeah, they're killing us. They're killing us. Bible's killing us. So this is the thing that the Holy Spirit has told us. So
let's just what a journey. Don't do it.
Sorry. Follow Jesus. Continue in His word. Now, that doesn't mean to say you got a word today.
Yeah.
You don't have a meal. You have a meal today, but you don't wait for the next day. You have another meal today. But the idea is that the word of God is rich and alive, but it's not. It comes back to the presence that Jesus said. You know, man shall not live by bread alone, but every word that comes from God. So. I think I have a lot more prepared, but I've decided to cut it down today because I want that word to sink in. If you are my disciple, continue in my word. But I'm going to go through next week the disciples, the various things that they learned along the way. And realizing Judas was a disciple, some of those things that are real that he was walking close, but he was used to fulfill the word of God. So really, I'll leave it there. Unless anyone's got any questions?
I just think of what you're saying. I've been challenged by so many people over the years, which is a true church.
Mm-hmm.
My sister got involved in the Adventists, which I have a great respect for some. My ex-wife was involved with the Mormons. My son got involved with the Jehovah's Witnesses, and every one of them proclaimed that they alone are the true church. That itself proves me false.
Mm.
You think about it. The kids do not appoint any male or female to represent the true church. He says, I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail.
Mm-hmm.
And when the Lord revealed that, that means that Jesus, in John 8:24, he's saying to the Jews that I am God, and you're perishing if you don't believe it.
Mm.
All these fruits with ism on the back of it, really presenting a cross that is not able to save you unless you're involved with it. Unless you do this or do that, Jesus does. What I've come to realize is that we are part of that glorious, wonderful, magnificent church that the Godhead, through Jesus, is building.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a privilege to be part of it. And Jeremiah 17:5 helped me so much in those troublesome times. And it says there that cursed is man that puts trust in man and makes flesh his strength. And all these isms have another addition to believing in Christ. There's many sincere people in all these groups, but there's two classes. One's the deceived. They know that something's not right. There are the deceivers that know it's not quite right. But I've come to know people that left all those truths, and I've learned a lot from it. So we are part of a true church that Jesus Christ is building, and the gates of hell will not prevail. So look up and rejoice.
Yes, that's right. May I say something? Might you comment there? I believe, I don't care about the labels. If it is A, B, or C, I don't care. But what I believe in the end of the remnant church, the two people that Peter here suggests to be disciples and spread the word, that is the idea will at the end be the remnant church. Are you okay? Are you okay with that?
The ones that are Jesus. Yes. Not being any man or woman.
Yeah, that's what I believe.
I mean,
a revelation is complete the answer, and the two last verses from Revelation gives the biggest hope.
It is, yeah.
Before we come around here, I've got one more song, and then we'll go. How are you holding up? It's been you're good.
Jesus Christ. No, I am not afraid to become. For every moment his hand has held mercy, for all the love that he's shown all my life. A simple thanks doesn't say how I'm feeling. I get tears in my eyes. So as for me, I'm gonna keep on believing in the one who's been so faithful to me. I'm not out to please this whole world around me. I've got my mind on eternity. That's why I am not ashamed of the gospel. The gospel of Jesus Christ. No, I am not afraid to be counted, but I'm willing to